Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking about the difference between looking old and looking tired. We've had a lot of people come in over the last couple weeks and say, I'm looking tired, I'm looking old. And partly it's the time of the year, the change of seasons, a little less sun, the tan fading away, and the loss of a bit of light. However, there is a difference. Typically, if looking old is the complaint, a lot of times we look to bone and bone structure. If the problem is looking tired, a lot of times it's loss of fat, and there's deep and there's superficial fat, and there's a difference. So when patients talk about looking old, think about bone structure. We talked about it last week, how important it is. And if we look at people who age very, very well, we can see they have great bone structure, particularly the zygomatic bone, the arch. And when we're doing fillers, of course, we use that bone to anchor with, say, Restylane Lift or Voluma. We use the bone to anchor and lift along the cheek line to lift the jawline. So we know the bone is important, and we also know when we're injecting a 25-year-old, the bone is large, it's easy to find. As people get older, 60, 70, 80 years old, the bone becomes narrow and it's easy to miss it when we're injecting. So the bone is very important. The other thing I want to mention is, where are the areas that age the most in bone in terms of what we see? There's the temple, okay, the eye socket widens, okay, we know that, but then there's the ramus or the angle of the jaw, okay, and not many people pay attention to that, but that's a must-fill, must-collagen-stimulate area because that lifts the edge of the mouth. And so the angle of the jaw often ignored. Also, we just talked about the zygomatic bone, we lose bone there. The piriform aperture, okay, and people are accustomed to filling the midface and the area, the perioral area, because those are FDA approved areas for fillers. So they're often filled. But it's important not to neglect the bone, meaning the temple area up high, and the angle of the jaw. That area has to be addressed. But not a lot of companies address that during the trainings. Why? It's off-label. So just injecting, say, the forehead, of course, with toxin, that can't be taught by the companies because it's off-label, although it's one of the trickiest areas to inject with toxin because we affect the brow shape, and lowering of the eyes is the only thing that can happen up here. So the point of it is, the bone is what changes, and when you see people and you don't see them, say, between age 45 and 55, and then you see them somewhere out and about, you might not recognize them. And it's typically not the fat changes that you're not recognizing, but it's the change in facial shape due to bone loss. So pay attention to the bone. If people are looking more tired, it's fat loss. If they're looking different or old, think about bone, bone loss, estrogen, hormonal influence, and that critical time between 45 and 55 in the female population where, of course, estrogen goes down, the skin changes, and bone loss accelerates. Thanks for joining me today. Join us on this YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.